Premier African Minerals has recorded significant lithium grades from its latest drilling at its Zulu lithium and tantalum project in Zimbabwe. I'm joined on the line now by Chief Executive George Roach. George, good to speak to you again. Bring us up to speed, first of all. What have these holes revealed?
Well, we are very excited that every hole that we have drilled so far, we're on the 9th and 10th holes at the moment. Everyone has intersected what is massive, visible, enriched lithium-bearing pegmatite material. We're very excited about it. We're obviously rushing through sample preparation, which we're doing ourselves in Zimbabwe, and then getting out material for assay as quickly as we can. The first assay results came in just the other day, and in I'm just trying to think, it was DD16. ZDD16 is the whole reference. We had a section of around about 20 meters of heavily mineralized lithium-bearing material that was grading at up to 2.67% Li2O. Very, very impressive. But to go with that was the fact that the length in the drill core, this is not necessarily true width, but the hole was at 45 degrees in this instance. So still impressive widths that we'll see. Some of these are as much as 5 meters. And, you know, that's coupled to the fact that the mineralized areas are distinctly different to the barren country rock is also likely to make an optical sort of mined ore very, very easy, and lead to what should be at some time in the future a very efficient mining operation as well. So generally very excited. We also reported some significant tantalum grades. That's a byproduct, but it's a nice to have byproduct. And that, of course, just adds to the very encouraging signs that we're seeing out of this project at the moment.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you. You're pretty confident here, George, that Zulu has some serious potential.
Well, it does. We've exposed a surface strike of quite a few kilometres in our surface exploration work, and it's open in the northerly direction still. Historic drilling had intersected mineralization at approximately 200 meters in depth, below surface, that is. We'd done a lot of trenching as well. We'd also done some work on alluvial tantalum opportunities surrounding the pegmatite. So all in all, we felt very good about this project before we even started drilling. And as I say, everything that we've done so far has supported the views that we have. It supports the model that we had worked out of this, the geological model. So I'm pretty excited going forward into the future with it.
Just out of interest, what do you reckon makes Zulu more attractive than the lithium brine projects that are out there?
Well, first of all, a hard rock lithium-bearing mineralization has uses beyond just lithium for battery purposes and as a metal. There is extensive demand into the industrial mineral sector. So there's always that as a backup to any oversupply, not that I believe there will be for a long time, in the lithium metal market. So that's the one. The other is that the grades are particularly high. 2.67% over, I think that was over 4 odd meters. I mean, that is a very, very good grade indeed. And that whole section of around about 20 and 28 meters running at an average of over 2%. That's really good mineralization.
George, the last time we spoke was following that acquisition of a limestone deposit in Mozambique. Any further developments there? Any updates we should know about?
Well, only that we are moving to the early stages of the exploration program. We will be on site and doing the surface mapping, dealing with any preparation work that we can in preparation for drilling. And all of that's going to happen now before the wet season. The wet season is around about a month away there. So we're really getting as much of the basic groundwork done now as we can. And immediately the wet season finishes, we will then look to drill on a pretty selective and efficient basis and move that forward very rapidly. In terms of its other operations, I have spoken about its existing cash generative operations. It's quite exciting to know that we have something that supports the exploration program. Gives us a very good hedge against the exploration spend and will contribute significantly as we go forward.
Just finally, George, I wanted to ask you, I know you've got a few plates spinning at the moment. You've got interests in lithium, tantalum, limestone, and of course gold. Any particular favourite, or are you equally excited about them all?
I have to say that the Zulu project at the moment I find particularly exciting. Gold is obviously very interesting in the present environment, and of course Donald's added a bit of a boost to that. So we find the gold project in the DRC through CASA a very interesting project, and that's going to just take a little bit of work to work out how we're going to go forward with it. Our interest at the moment is small. I'd like to see that as a much more substantial interest. I believe that the project has a lot of merit and a lot of upside as well. We're looking at it in-house. We have our own in-house resource geos, having a very good look at the resource and the plans for that going forward. And we hope to be able to add efficient value to the efforts of CASA in the very near future.
Always good to speak to you, George. All the best. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much indeed.